Hi there. As you can see, videos are a great way to grab attention at the start of your presentation. If you kick off with a title slide with a nice looping video and maybe even some light music, your presentation will stand out, giving your audience something pleasant to look at while they wait for you to begin, signaling to them that you are willing to go a step further than most presenters to engage them. Luckily, PowerPoint 365 now has an amazing collection of stock videos that you can add to your presentations. The way to access them is to go to Insert, Video, Stock Video, and then choose whichever ones you want, and then go ahead and insert. Super easy to do. Just make sure you have PowerPoint 365, the subscription, and you should see that option displayed. And by the way, it's not just videos that they have in the library. They now have a ton of new stock photos, icons, stickers, and people cutouts as well, definitely increasing your creative options. Now back to the videos. Once you have the video in here, for title slides, I like to just have the animation start with previous, which is automatically what it is when it's inserted. I just take out this trigger here as well. You can definitely use videos in other parts of your presentation too, not just the title slide, but I think kicking off with video is a very powerful and relatively easy way to spice up your presentation. There are videos for so many occasions and every season as well in here. So that's really the basics of inserting stock videos, and now I'll give you a few advanced tips on using them and a cool bonus trick at the end that you can do with any video. Make sure the video has a seamless loop. In other words, it loops in a way that makes sense visually and doesn't induce motion sickness or discomfort in your audience, since that would be, of course, defeating the purpose of using videos in the first place. Some of the videos in here are perfectly looped, such as this one here. Their loop is seamless and subtle, making them a perfect fit for a title slide. Others, however, such as this climbing video, are nice for maybe using in the middle of a presentation, maybe starting out as a still image and then coming to life as you're talking. But the loop on this climbing one doesn't really fit a title slide because it will just become tiring to look at because it's so short and loops often and isn't really that subtle. So that's kind of my tip number one. Make sure the video has a seamless loop. Number two, choose a video that has a very subtle motion. So subtlety is something I talked about earlier, but even if it has a seamless loop, try to choose a video that is relatively slow and subtle in motion. This video, for example, is nice and slow, which brings a sense of movement, but in a comforting way. This video, on the other hand, loops seamlessly, but is so fast that at least for me, it induces much more discomfort or maybe anxiety for being so fast. One thing you can do if you have a video editor is to save the videos by going Save As, and then slow them down in another program, and then re-import and use those. That's exactly what I did with the smoke at the beginning of this video, for instance. And finally, for a very quick title page design, what you could do is select and copy the video, then open a new slide and put in your presentation title. I can then right click and paste the video as an image by choosing this paste image here. This pulls up Microsoft's designer tool. You can now use this to get some AI-based designs of different layouts, some definitely more promising than others. So choose on here, and now open the selection pane, then paste the video again as a video this time, then drag this down to the same spot where the image is, and then delete the image. And now the videos will play within the design. And if you're a professional designer, I'm sure you can do a fantastic job yourself without needing this. But for those who need a quick AI-based fix, like I often do, this is a great option as well. So those are my advanced tips from using video. And as promised, I'll now show you a bonus trick with video design, which is video stamping. If you have the merge shape tools, you can actually cut out any shape from the video by overlaying the two, selecting both. Just make sure you click on the video first, by the way, to keep that format. And then select fragment. That's the one I like best since it keeps all the pieces together. And there you go. You can stamp out text or any kind of design. You can even make video icons or use video portions as design accents as well. Well, once again, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Comment, like, and subscribe with notifications. And see you for my next video.